So the first thing I want to say is, if you get away from using the bell ringers that Caitlin mentioned earlier, the wacky word Wednesday ones, you're automatically going to build in more engagement, right? Because you're taking away the mundane routine that students face every day. If they know that every single Tuesday, they're going to define a vocabulary word and use it in a sentence, they're going to get bored pretty quickly and they're going to stop giving it their best effort. But if they sit down for bell work every day and it's a completely different expectation, you know, within the same parameters, it's going to keep them on their toes and keep them thinking. So you're going to get better quality work from them. So instead, we want to aim to use bell ringers that change at least every week, ideally every day, right? But Caitlin mentioned maybe 1 week is narrative writing, 1 week is reviewing grammar, 1 week is something fun and unexpected, right? We've got holidays throughout the year. Why not have some fun with our students for those parts of the year? Keep it academic, keep it standards aligned, but throw in a bit of, creativity. Yeah. So it's when you're using bell ringers, just keeping in mind how to have different expectations each week for your students, and then you're going to ensure that they're engaged.
Yeah.
That was pretty simple.
It is. The second part of the question was all about grading, right? How do I grade them? Should I grade them or not? So I want to talk about that really briefly right now. So one of the things that I would do is I would simply use some of that time while students are working on their bell ringers to just walk around and make sure that they're on track. It's actually really cool because if I'm walking around while they're working on their bell ringers and I can see, oh my gosh, this student is still struggling with this concept that we had finished months ago or a couple weeks ago, and they're still not getting it. Well, now I can see, hey, I need to come back to this concept for this particular student or offer them more support, maybe through IXL or whatever other programs right. you use that can support them in that capacity. So that's really helpful in terms of just grading and being like, okay, like participation, you know, doesn't have to be massive grades and things like there doesn't have to be this huge weight on bell ringers. So that's one thing that I did. Another thing that I did as well that I found successful was that students only had a certain amount of time each class period that they could work on the bell ringers. So this will totally depend on the length of your class period. You might only have 5 minutes to do this or 10 minutes to do this with your students. But I always put on the board, hey, you'll have until 9:05 to complete your bell ringer for today. And they're only working on one little section for the day. So that keeps them on task. Right? And that allows you that time to quickly go over the answers too, if you need to with your students. So it's not even a grade. They're just working on it. You're walking around if you need to, and then you go over the questions together with your students. So it's, again, I think not putting a ton of weight on that grading portion. And then going along with that, just don't grade everything. You know, not every single thing in life needs to have a grade attached to it. There has to be some sort of intrinsic motivation for our students to accomplish things and get things done without a grade. And that takes pressure off of them too. Our students have so much pressure in their lives. We don't need to grade every single little piece of work that they turn into us. The other thing that I've done in the past is I would just pick like one day of the week's activity and grade that portion for completion or for correctness, depending on what you want to do. And really the easiest way that I did it is I just checked whether or not, boom, Monday done, Tuesday done, whatever. And they got a participation grade that was a nominal percentage of their grade, but enough that they wanted to make sure that they put that effort forth. So don't put a ton of like weight on that. Don't stress out about grading the bell ringers. I think it's more of using them as a way to help you have strong classroom management. It creates a calm environment when your students come into the classroom. They know exactly what they're doing. No class time is wasted. They also get to spiral review all of these standards, and it helps you kind of pinpoint where students are still struggling with certain concepts. So look at the grading as kind of like the secondary thing for the purpose of bell ringers that you're using in your classroom. All right. Thanks so much for joining us, you guys. And we will see you next week on the podcast.
Bye.